Hi friends, my name is Deepak and you have tuned in to All About Software Testing. Here you get information related to software testing from time to time. Please make sure that you subscribe to my channel for getting all the information regularly. So today's our topic is severity of defects and priority of defects. So we'll study about each of these topics in detail. The first one is severity of defects and the second one is priority of defects. So let's continue our video with our first topic, that is severity of defects. So our first topic is severity of defect. So the definition of severity states that severity is the extent to which the defect can affect the software or an application. So it defines the extent to which the defect can have the impact on the software or application. Severity defines the impact of defect on the system or software. So it is a parameter that defines the impact of the defect on the system or software. So if the defect is of high severity, then it will have more effect on the system in contrast to the defect of the low severity. For example, when user clicks on a link and the page of the application crashes, so the severity of this defect will be high. So as we see that if the user clicks on a link on the page and the application crash, so the user will not be able to use that application. So the severity of this defect will be high. So we will study about the types of severity of defects. First one is critical. The defects or bugs that can result in termination of the complete software or one or more components of the software are categorized as of critical severity. The failed function is unusable and there are no alternative methods to do that work. So is that if the defect is of critical severity, the function that the user wants to use will not be usable and there will not be any other alternative method to do that work. So the defect will be categorized as of critical severity. Next type is major type. The defects or bugs that results in stoppage of complete system or one or more module of software. The failed function is unusable, but there are alternative ways to do that work. So for example, if a link present on one page is failed to load, so the user is not able to use that link from that page, but there are other pages that where the link is also present. So the user can navigate to that page and use that functionality. So this will be categorized as of major severity. Next type is moderate type. The defect or bug does not stop or terminate any functionality but causes the software to produce incorrect or inconsistent output. So the functionality that is present, the functionality is working, but the output that the functionality is giving is not correct. So the defect will be categorized as of moderate severity. So for example, if we want to check our mails, so we will click on inbox button. So when we click on inbox button, the Gmail application will redirect us to the my profile page. So the function is working, but it is not working correctly. So that defect will be categorized in the moderate severity. Next is minor severity. The defects that cause no termination or stoppage of the system, the desired outputs can be obtained by any another available function. So for example, we want in a calculator, we want to use the multiplication function to find out the result of 2 multiplied by 3. So the function is not working properly. So we can get the output by adding 2 3 times. 2 plus 2 plus 2 equal to 6. So we get the same output that we get from the multiplication function by using the addition function. So this type of defect will be categorized as minor severity defect. Next type of defect is cosmetic defect. Cosmetic defect is related to the changes that are related to the look and feel of the application. So the defects that comes in the look and feel of the application are categorized as cosmetic defects. Cosmetic defects contains, for example, spelling mistakes on the page or mistakes in the brand or the logo of the website. These all comes under the cosmetic defects. So the defects, these type of defects will be categorized as the cosmetic type of defects. Now we will study about the priority of defects. Priority of defects. Priority defines the sequence in which the defects should be resolved by the developing team. The priority of defects is set by tester to developer having the time frame to fix the bug. So priority defines the sequence in which the defect is to be fixed by the developing team. So the priority is set by the tester on the basis of which the developing team decides the sequence of the defect to be fixed. The priority of defect is set on the basis of customer requirement. So if the customer wants that this defect is to be fixed urgently, the priority will be set as high and the developing team will first fix that defect and then fix any other defect present there. So the priority of defect is set by the customer requirements. So now we will study about the types of priority. The first type is low priority. The priority of the defect is set as low when the defect is an irritant and can be fixed later after more serious defects. So for example, we have a page of application where the records are displayed. So we have a search functionality on that page so that the user can search the records present there. And the defect is that the records that are displayed are not in the alphabetical order. So this will be categorized as low priority defect because the user have a functionality to search using the search to search the records. So the records to be present in the alphabetical order is of low priority, and the developing team will fix this type of defect later on. Next type is medium type. The priority of defect is set as medium when the defect can be fixed in normal course of development. So the defect that is not of high priority, so it is not like that the defect is to be fixed right now by the dev team, but it can be fixed in the normal course of development when all the defects are reported and the dev team will work on all the defects. So then this type of defect will be taken care of. The next type of priority is high priority. The priority of defect is set as high when the defect is affecting the software or product severely. The system is unusable without the defect is fixed by the dev team. So if a defect is present there in the software which is affecting the software, that the software is unusable by the end user, so that type of defect will be of the high priority and the dev team will have to fix that defect right now so that the user will be able to use that software. So for example, when a user clicks on the login button, he is not able to log in the application even if he is using the right credential for the login. So this type of defect is categorized as high priority defect and the dev team have to fix that defect with urgent priority. So now we will study some interview questions related to severity and priority that are asked in interviews frequently. So the first question that is asked is high priority and high severity example. So the defects which occur on basic functionality of the software and is not allowing the user to use the system or software. So this type of defects are categorized in high priority and high severity type of defect. So for example, a website having details of students, when the user saves a record, it doesn't allow the user to save the new record. So it is a very basic functionality that the user is trying to save record of the students and the website or the software is not allowing the user to save the records. So it is of high priority because the user is not able to save the records of the new students, and it is of high severity because it is allowing the system to not respond properly. And in other words, we can say that the system is failing completely so that the user is not able to use that software. So this is categorized as high priority and high severity type of defect. Next is high priority and low severity defects. The spelling errors on the cover page or the main page of a website or application are categorized in high priority and low severity defects. So these are categorized as high priority because there is some mistake in the cover page of the website or on the logo of the website is not correct. So it is of high priority because it is affecting the business of the software, and it is of low severity because this is not stopping the system to work properly, and this is not crashing the software. These type of defects. So these type of defects are categorized in high priority and low severity type of defects. Next is high severity and low priority defects. So defects which occur on the functionality of the software which does not have any workaround and is not allowing user to use the system on click of a remote link. So it is of low priority because the user is clicking on a remote link that is present somewhere in the corner of the page. So it is categorized as low priority, and it is high severity because when the user clicks on that link, their software is crashing completely, so that the user is not able to use that software. So it is categorized as high severity and low priority defects. Next is low priority and low severity defects. So any cosmetic defects on a paragraph or in a report, not on cover page or heading, is categorized in low priority and low severity type of defects. So it is categorized as low severity because the defects are just cosmetic defects, like there is spelling mistake in the paragraph or a report that is generated by the user, and it is of low priority because the defect is not present on the cover page or on the login page of this on the application. So the defect is present inside that application or inside some module that where the user generates the report or the paragraph that is present there in the description of that page. The spelling mistakes are present in that. So it will be categorized as low priority and low severity type of defects. That's all for today's video. If you like my video, then hit the like button. And if you have any doubts or queries, you can post in the comment section. And please make sure that you subscribe to my channel for getting the videos regularly. Thank you.